Hi guys, welcome back to another edition of Max and Nicky 1000th Time Reactions,
where we react to a song after listening to it for our 1000th time.
We normally would release three videos a day.
And we usually do that every day.
But for this week, we're only doing one a day.
Maybe two.
Maybe two if we have some time, but we are...
It's a very busy week for
us. It's a very busy week. I have personally a deadline for a project on November 1st. So next week we'll start...
Get back to doing three a day.
But for right now, we are doing one a day, at least every day.
And if you're new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button and ding that post notification bell
so you don't miss out on any of our content.
Mm-hmm. So what are you going to listen to right now, Max?
We're going to listen to The Logical Song by Supertramp.
Mm, love this song. Mm-hmm. Off a really great album, Breakfast in America.
Yeah.
One of the albums that we bought when we were in high school, actually.
I think we got it for Christmas, I want to say. I think our mom got it for Christmas.
When we were in high school?
Yeah.
Yeah. If you're new to the channel, what we do on here is we listen to a song all the way through without stopping so as not to interrupt the intention of the artist. And then afterward, we talk about our reaction, go into some in-depth analysis about the song, and maybe talk a little about the history about the song and the artist if we should know it.
We also have another YouTube channel called Max and Nicky, if you're interested, on which we perform oldies tunes, jazz standards, and some original tunes as well. And we got some comedy videos on there, too. But for right now, let's take a listen to Supertramp's The Logical Song.
For our 1,000th time.
Here we go.
Joyfully, oh, playfully, watching.
Man, that song is a really well produced song. Yeah,
it's very well produced.
There's so many sounds and instruments going on. They all fit so perfectly in place.
I believe Roger Hodges, that's his name, right?
Right.
I believe he's the one that I think he produced. I think he actually mixed it too.
Really?
Because I could swear I read the story that he was, you know, after they recorded, he would go back down to the recording studio at night and start mixing it, actually.
Oh, really? Wow.
Something like that. I think I want to say they may have had a deadline even, actually, and he just was like, I want this to be the best as possible, and he wanted to, you know, make sure of that or something.
I mean, this album has such great songs on it. Goodbye Stranger, you can check out our reaction video to that one. That was one of the first reaction videos we did when we started the channel. That's one of our favorite songs of all time, actually. And you have this song on the same album. I mean, it's like...
There's a lot. There's Breakfast in America.
Take the Long Way Home.
Yeah.
They got some hits on this album for sure. Mm-hmm. And there's so many cool things. I mean, first of all, you got that saxophone that's really utilizing that harmonic minor scale in a way that kind of gives it almost...
Wait, harmonic? Are you sure it's using a harmonic minor? Yeah, maybe you're right.
Well, it gives it that sort of almost kind of a Yiddish kind of feel.
No, it's not a harmonic minor.
Is it not?
I think it's what's called the... they do call it like the Jewish-Spanish scale, actually.
Well, that's what he's using. What are the notes in that scale?
I think there's like a flat 9. Mm-hmm. Oh boy, I can't remember too. I forgot.
Well, why don't you look it up while I keep talking?
All right.
But it does have that sort of Jewish kind of sound to it, you know, that you would find in Jewish music.
That's right. It's called it's also otherwise known as a Phrygian dominant scale, but keep talking. Go ahead.
And man, the saxophone is really wells on this song, you know? I mean, they really utilize it really well. I actually started, the first instrument I learned was the saxophone, and I played it for many, many years. I still do play it occasionally, although, you know, Max and I both sing and play guitar and piano and keys, and you can't really sing and play the saxophone at the same time. But occasionally I'll break out the saxophone and play it, and on our albums that we record, I'll add saxophone to that, some of the tracks sometimes. I'm just talking about myself now. But, you know, a saxophonist can appreciate good saxophone playing, and that's what's happening on this song, actually.
So it's basically like a Phrygian scale, if you're familiar, Phrygian mode, which is a minor kind of scale, but it has a flat second, you know?
Or flat 9.
Well, no, I'm talking about a Phrygian scale. Gotcha. So the second scale degree is flattened. Mm-hmm. But it is a Phrygian dominant scale, so the third is not minor, it's major, actually.
Mm-hmm.
So it's basically, you know, so that's what it is. You know, we don't want to belabor it too
much
more
than that. Anyway.
Or it could be using what's known as the double harmonic scale, which is related to that.
So the double harmonic scale.
Yeah.
I was not too far off.
Well, no, that could be something else. That's also called the Byzantine scale, Arabic.
Well, let's
scale.
Not get too into it, though.
Yes, let's not get.
we're belaboring just over this saxophone part because there's a lot more going on in this song. You know, I love in the bridge, the second time the bridge comes around, where the background vocals come in. You know, I just love that part. You know, there were times when. And then
the background vocals come in. Yeah, it's not only they're placed very well in the stereo spectrum in the mix, and they're the volume just is perfect on it. You know, it just seems to work so well.
Also, when it goes dun, 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 like in that bridge, you know, part where it's a, and you hear all these guitars come in at that part, it kind of makes it a bigger sound.
I was going to say, you hear the guitars come in and then they go away,
right,
for a moment. Cool. It's inspiring to hear that. It makes me think, yes, we should do, sometimes yes, when yes, we're, yes.
Sound like Jeff Goldblum.
Right. When, yes, yes. Sometimes yes, when yes, we're producing it. Stuff, I, there's a tendency
to want to keep an instrument in there the whole time.
No, that's not what I was going to say. I was going to say there's kind of like this, once you introduce an instrument, then you kind of tend to keep it there for the rest of the song.
But you don't need to.
But you don't need to. And I'm not saying we necessarily do that, but maybe we tend to keep it for the rest of, you know, the chorus or that verse or something like that.
Are you talking about one particular song that we're working
on? No, no, or maybe, I don't know. Just, I feel like that's a tendency of mine to do, but I like that they're just doing it for one phrase, mm-hmm. and then it goes away, and then it comes back later on, you know, within, you know, maybe a few more bars later on down the road.
Sure.
And I think that's an interesting thing to keep note of, actually. You know, I think that's cool. Not to say the way I'd been doing it is the wrong way, but it's inspiring to hear.
But, you know, even there's a point where the organ comes in the song and, you know, it goes away and just placed so perfectly. But there's a cowbell at the end there, you know? You're not really introduced to it until kind of toward the end, which is pretty cool. You got these hand claps that happen.
Well, also, you have this sound effect that's like, brruh, 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 or whatever, you know?
Sure, you also have that whistle.
It reminds me of like some sort of computer, right? Like something out of some science fiction movie or something like that.
Well, you also
you only hear that at the end, that sound effect, you know?
You also have the...
I think once even only.
What is it? The whistle. What is it called?
Slide whistle?
Yeah, slide whistle, and then you got the castanets, right?
Castanets, yeah. I almost think the way it was done, well, maybe they were just thinking, oh, let's do some castanets. I wonder if there was some, you know, they were inspired by, what is it, Be My Baby, you know, maybe.
Maybe, I don't know.
I feel like,
but the drums also-
anytime you hear castanets in a pop tune, you got to think, oh, they were inspired by Be My Baby, you know?
Even when the drums first come in, you hear these toms that are
I think it's really cool. It does this fill from the toms over here to over here. It's pretty cool.
It's like the drums fill out the whole stereo spectrum. But yeah. The drums are so well engineered too, actually, in this song.
Yeah, and then there was another thing I can't remember.
Well, there's lots of things going on. It's just, you know, you'd have to be writing down notes, you know, to keep track of everything, because there's so many cool things going on.
And also, let's just not forget, it's a very catchy melody. Mm-hmm.
I've never really tried to decipher the lyrics to this song, and I don't think we'll do that right now.
Right. I think what's cool, I mean, for me, why I appreciated and fell in love with Supertramp stuff, when I first was introduced to them, were their
melodies.
Were their infectious melodies. And then later on down the road, I became more conscious of their production. And I'm even becoming, right this very moment, right now, as we're talking about it, when we just listened to it, I've discovered new things about it, because I haven't really focused on these smaller things in the past
thing.
Before.
Here's the deal. You know? When we bought this album in high school, you know, we wore this album out, but
sure, but we
wore
not,
it out on a CD player, not using headphones.
Yeah, we didn't use headphones, and I didn't.
And it was a boombox. This is our own boombox, so it wasn't
like.
Well,
no, I also played it on my laptop. You know, right before I went to college,
or
you know,
even we would listen to it in our car. You know,
or listen in the car. Yeah,
driving to and from school, high school. You know, but and the thing about it is, in those settings, you're not really getting the full, you know, experience.
You're just getting sort of a big picture.
You're getting a big picture. You're not getting the details, you know?
And, I mean, it's not only in, maybe in the last 10 years is when I started becoming more conscious of production, you know? Especially, I guess, in 2010 to 2011, I did take a class at a conservatory that was music and computers.
In Paris.
You don't got to mention that. It's all good. But yes.
Max tries to be so modest sometimes. Maybe to his detriment. I don't know.
What do you mean? It wasn't actually in Paris proper. It was actually on the outskirts of... it was in metropolitan Paris, I guess, but it was in the banlieue. It was in the suburbs of Paris, but okay. The teachers were really cool, and it was the first time I thought to be inspired by listening to the production of songs, you know.
The Arrière-Pays. That's in Nice, right? Was what we were talking about before.
Well, it could be anywhere.
Sure, but specifically when you went to Nice.
Yeah,
right?
yeah.
Sorry, we both studied in France. I studied in Lyon. He studied in Paris. But
sure. So I became aware of just production at that time, and then I didn't. I kind of stopped. Like thinking about it for a couple years. And then when we started producing our own music, or actually even when we were working with somebody else producing our own music, then we became aware of stuff again.
And you know, I started becoming very aware of like good bass lines and stuff. And what's funny is I didn't even focus that much on the bass in this listen of this song just now, because there's so many things going on that are cool.
Sure.
There's a lot of things you can choose to focus on.
Right, and it's kind of interesting. I mean, if you're curious, you can kind of see the growth of how we produce stuff. If you're curious, you know, our band is called Little Person, and if you want to look that up, littlepersonband.com, you can see like our first EP is fairly minimal as far as production goes.
It's a little kind of nuts and bolts, you know, kind of.
Nuts and bolts. Yeah, okay.
We didn't have the mindset to be like, oh, we should be doing a lot more here.
Right, know? Like let's add more harmonies. And it's still, I think it sounds great, but then if you listen to our next album after that, our next EP, then that's the first time we produced, first time we just decided to take a stab at mixing and engineering ourselves. And so we were able to spend a lot more time and we added a lot more stuff. And then, you know, this new album, I think we're refining that process more, you know, I feel.
Sorry if you're hearing seems to be a truck backing out next to us.
But that's okay. That's part of the production.
You know what?
Anyway, we've gone way too long.
I think that'll do for this reaction video. If you like what you heard and saw today, make sure to hit that subscribe button and ding that post notification bell to find out about more Max and Nicky reaction videos.
Please keep tuning in.